This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, everyone just look at here. So what is an internal database in Pega and what is an external database means? Okay, see, we are creating many rules in VRBase, like rules like properties, sections, flow actions, flows, classes, any rule that you create, that rule is going to get saved into the background database tables. In some of the tables, let's say for example, when you create a property, in which table it will get stored? In which table property gets stored? Property gets stored into rule obj property related table pr4 underscore property. Suppose if you create a section, rule html section class related table, that is pr4 underscore something. Okay, and you create a data type. When you create a data type, it is going to create a class, it is going to create a physical table in the backend with prefix PR underscore and what else, class and table mapping properties, everything will be created, like report definitions, data pages, all this. See, the tables that are going to be created automatically are getting created into one of the database for which our PRPC environment is already had a connection. Okay, so let me open that environment and show you. So here you go, Pega 8.1 and databases. We have already have a database, Postgres. Okay, database name can be anything, it depends on your business what database name that they're going to do. Any tables that you create, data types, tables gets created into this database. Similarly, all your rules are available in rule schema here. So the tables where all your rules get stored. So this is related to your PRPC rule base. Okay, now here if you go ahead, rule base tables, another schema, that is data schema. Where is data schema? Data schema. Your PC tables like PC assign work list, PC work related, all the tables are getting stored into another schema. So whatever the schema is, now let's talk about this database. So the database where your rules are getting stored and your work table is getting created and your assign dash work list, work basket tables are available, that is Pega's rule base, that is called internal database. Okay, so we are not required to do any mappings, we are not required to create queries and all. Automatically everything gets generated and everything mappings will be done automatically, the rules will be automatically created. Now coming to the term external database, suppose if you look at here, other than this database what we see here, Postgres, we have many other databases. Maybe it is the same environment or it can be a different database server. It can be same database server environment or a different environment of different server. It can be Oracle server, it can be DB2 server, it can be any server or any environment, whatever it is. The database which is like outside one, so it is not related to Pega BRPC environment at all. So then that database is called as external database. Okay, where you will not see any rule based tables like PR4 operator, all this you will not see. You will just see some tables related to some business. Now that is called as external database. So any database which is not rule based, other than rule based, any other database is considered to be an external database for Pega PRPC environment. Now in the external database, there can be some tables available and all. If you wanted to access that external database tables from PRPC environment, there are two possible ways. That is, one is using OBJ methods. OBJ methods you can use, like OBJ browse, OBJ open, OBJ save, OBJ delete, these methods. Okay, we can go ahead and use and fetch the data from the external database and save the data into external database. Another possible way is we can use different methods called RDB methods. RDB methods means we have RDB methods like this: RDB list and RDB save, RDB delete, RDB open. So RDB list is going to fetch multiple records from the database table, external table. RDB save is going to save one record to the table, or it can be used to update a record in the table. RDB delete, it can be used to delete an instance from the table, and RDB open is to fetch one single record based on primary key. Okay, this is clear, everyone. So now the database where your rules get stored and your PR tables gets created and your work table, work list table are available generally. That is, by default, all these are available. That is rule base or internal database. Any other database other than rule base is called as external database. So PRBC environment can communicate with external database also, third party databases. In order to communicate with external database, it can do it by using either of the two different types of methods. One is OBJ methods and second one is RDB methods. Differences I'll tell you later. Okay, now generally it's not about Pega, any technology application. If the application wants to communicate with any database, okay, it requires below parameters. First one is connection URL is required. Connection URL or connection string, you call them. Connection URL is required. So database, when you install on a server, you need to generate a URL where this database is available. That URL you have to provide to someone. Connection URL, along with that, you need a username and password. All this is required. Okay. So taking these two details, if you configure in your application, then your application is going to be connected to external database. It can be any database. Okay. Generally, these details will be provided to you by DBAs, database administrators. Okay. So let's see now how to create a new database in PG Admin 4 environment. After that, I will talk about RDB methods. I'll talk about how to fetch the data from RDB method. Only up to database we'll see. Generally, creating databases and creating tables inside database, all this is not our work generally. It is the work of DBAs. After they have created everything, they will share us a URL for connection purpose. They'll share us username and password if required, details. Then our work starts integrating PRBC application with external database. This is clear, everyone. Let's go ahead now and see how to create a database in the PG Admin 4 environment. Okay. This is just for your information. How to create DB in DB and tables PG Admin 4 in Gaadu using. See these steps, what we're going to see now, it is very generic with respect to PG Admin 4 environment. If you go to Google and if you type in Google how to create database, how to create tables in using PG Admin 4 environment, you will get navigations of what I'm going to tell now. 567, right? I'll say with the same name. Now let's go ahead and create it. So create a new database, new external database. Name, I'll give name. What is the name? What is our application? AAA, right? AAA EXTDB. Okay. And create a new table to store win detail to fetch. Create a new table, let's say win details. This is the table name. Okay. Win details. You know the columns, right? Already. Those columns you have to make win as a primary key. So let me write down for your information. While we access, okay, PG Admin for it. PG Admin server. PG Admin server. Okay. Just give me one minute. While working with You need to remember this. PG admin environment. Make sure the names of database, comma, tables and columns must be all lowercase. All lowercase, no uppercase at all. That is not being supported by PG admin. During the runtime, you will face issues, not while creating. Okay. So for our practice to go on plain, you just go ahead and make sure while giving the database names, table names and column names, lowercase. But this is not the same case when you are working with enterprise application with other databases. This is only restriction for PG admin. Okay. Other databases can be anything. Now this is the environment. Right click on the database and choose create database. Okay, let me create a database. Creating database, and here you go. And database, you will get this pop up where you have to provide the name of the database. What is the name of the database? AAAExtDB. Let's say AAAExtDB. And owner and all, I'm not pretty much sure about all the parameters in databases because I'm not pretty much aware of in depth about databases. Let's go with plain details and definition. Security, you need to provide access to it. Okay, go to security tab. And add required privileges. Okay, so here you go. Privileges. What are the privileges? I'm not pretty much sure about giving specific privileges. I'll give all. So click on plus icon. Once you click on plus icon here, you will see something like this. From the list, you can choose Postgres and privileges. You click on privileges, you need to select all, just simply, and click on save. Okay, this is completed. Save this. I think it should create a database now. Database is created. Look at here now. Now the database is created. Where is the database? AAExtDB. Right click on this. Simply you can refresh it, then it will be connected. But that red color into mark means connection is not done. Now, if you simply click on this, it will be connected, and then schemas, public schema is by default available. Okay, by default, DB has public schema created. Let's use the same. I am not going to create a new schema at all. Now, let's create a table. Create a table. So, what is the table that we wanted to create for win details, right? So, here you go. Schema, and after that tables, right click on this, create table. So this is the window where you can go and give the name of the table. What is the name of the table? Win details and Postgres schema. Okay, everything is okay. Other than that, I'm not going to do anything. And here you go, columns. What are the columns that I want? You can go ahead and add it. Go to columns tab. Once you go to columns tab, here you go. Click on plus icon to add a new column. Column name I wanted to give win. This is varchar or character varying, something like this. And so this one I want it to be not null. I want it to be primary key. Okay. So this is a primary key column. Win after, I wanted to add more columns.
Harsha, what is character varying?
It's a data type in the database, like integer, text property, we are choosing, right? Like text property. Model. Make year, I want it to be integer, right? Make year. make here integer and begin something like this. Okay, done. Now like this, you have chosen some data types for this one, and then primary key and everything you have given, go to security tab. Now these columns you wanted to give permissions to the table. Go to security tab. So here also similarly how we had add privileges previously, same way click on this and grant permission for Postgres, and is all I wanted to give, and then save this. Save, done, completed. Now if you go back and see, table is created here with four columns, that is win, company, model, make here. Right click on the table and view data, first 100 rows. Now the table has no data as of now. Let's put some test data. Win 001. I'll give a different data than previous one. What is that? So company and model, and what is the next one? Make year 2017, like this. You can add one more column. Once you click on save, it will add, sorry, row, one more row, 2017. Win 002. This one, tell me some company name. And here you go, L11, something like this, 2019. Okay. Now save this, only 2019. Done, completed. Some test data I have added in the backend table. Save, done, completed. This is how you can go ahead and create database in external database. Now this database is not related to Pega. It is not connected to PRBC environment at all. Suppose if you wanted to, if your PRBC environment has to interact with this table and fetch the data, what we have to do is, first from PRBC environment, we have to make a connection to this database. First step is database connection from PRBC environment. And next one is, from PRBC environment, we need to connect to table, external database table. So for connecting to database, we need to create a database rule. For connecting to table, we need to create database table mapping rule. Before that, we need to create a data class, and then class we need to map to table. For that mapping rule, we have to create properties and all, we have to create in the front end, which are exactly matching with the name what we see here, columns. If not matching, what we should do, I'll tell you later. Okay, this is clear. So everyone clear with this? And after you are done with all these steps, I think previously we did not do any time creating database table mapping rules. Now we will do it manually. Now, in order to interact with the database tables and all, to retrieve the data, save data, delete data and all, update data, we need to go ahead and use OBJ methods. Suppose if you are using OBJ methods, after your database connection is done, database table class mapping is done, and then you are using OBJ methods. OBJ open, OBJ save, OBJ browse, like this. All these methods will automatically generate queries. You're not required to write queries. You can use that methods. This is clear. Suppose if you're using RDB methods, let me show you. Technical, create, activity, and RDB methods. See, RDB list. First method, and second one, I want, suppose if I wanted to go and get RDB open, RDB save, RDB delete. You look at here, for RDB list method, what are the main parameters we'll talk about? Request type, access, and name of the class. What should be the class name here? What should be the class name? Chapati. The class which is mapped to the table. Okay, and coming to this one, the other one, RDB open. You have open class, request type and access. Here you see, here also you have request type and access, open class. And same parameters. And if you go to RDB save also, same parameters. And if you go to RDB delete also, same. So all four different methods have same parameters. Okay, now here you go. Whenever you are using RDB methods, these methods will not generate queries automatically. It will not generate. Okay, so these methods can be used for the purpose of executing queries which are already written. Okay, so if you wanted to execute any of the queries which are already available, then you have to go to RDB methods. In BRPC, queries can be written by using a rule called connect SQL. Create this one, integration connectors, connect SQL, and here you go, RDB open request type and access, right? So here you go. Now you give a label ABC, applies to class, table class and package name. Okay, so table class can be in whatever the table that you wanted to fetch from. Package name is test, let's say test. Okay, create and open. Now you see label and package name I have given, right? All the parameters you'll see on top, test, package name. Okay, now here you go. If you expand it, open class you will give and request type and access. If you mouse over onto these parameters, ABC, it is showing request type. So what is the request type you have to pass here? ABC. And here the term access value is equal to package name value here. So package name here is equal to, so you need to fill this package name test here, you have to give access and request type ABC, request type you have to give and the name of the class. Oh, I'm sorry, where is the request type ABC and name of the class. Holding these three parameters, what it can identify when RDB open this one is executed, taking this parameter and this parameter, it can go ahead and look up for a connect SQL rule with the same name. So connect SQL rule name is combination of class name and what is that package name and request type. All these parameters it will find out one connect SQL rule in BRPC. That connect SQL rule should be executed. In the connect SQL rule, you can write down your own queries. Okay, any queries you wanted to write down, you can go ahead and write down your own queries. Now when it executes connect SQL rule, it has to execute the query. It will execute the query. But if you can see here, in a connect SQL rule, we have multiple different tabs. The main tabs open, delete, save, browse. These four tabs, you can go ahead and write down your queries. Suppose if you're going to write a query in open tab, you have to write a query which is going to return one record based on primary key. So select from so and so table where condition is equal to based on primary key, it will retrieve one record. So one record, if you wanted to retrieve based on primary key, then that query you have to return in open tab and you have to write in open tab. If you wanted to write delete query, then write it in delete tab. If you wanted to write down insert or update query, then you have to write it in the save tab. If you wanted to write multiple records fetching more than one record in list format, then you have to write the respective query in browse tab. Like this, whenever you are going to use any RDB method, it finds and pass the parameter, it finds the connect SQL rule to execute. But in a connect SQL rule, we have four queries. Which tab it has in four different tabs? Open, save, delete, browse. In which tab it has to execute? When it comes here, it will not execute four tabs, it will execute only one of the tab. That will be decided by BRPC based on the method name from which you have called this particular query. If you are using RDB open method, then same query and passing these parameters, same rule will, this rule will be executed. If you are using RDB list and passing these same parameters, it is going to execute the same rule. If you use RDB open, RDB delete and pass the same parameters, all four methods will point to same rule when you pass these parameters. But where RDB list will execute only browse tab, RDB save method will execute only save tab, RDB delete method will execute delete tab, and RDB open method will execute the query which is available in open tab. So method name identifies which tab to be executed here. Okay, and the three parameters will identify which rule to execute. This is clear, everyone? So we cannot write down more than one query in the tabs. Everyone clear? So like this, your RDB methods are going to execute a connector scale rule. Based on the method name, it will execute one of the tab in the connector scale rule. The query which is there in the respective tab will get executed at runtime, and the return results will be placed on the clipboard after that same process what we have learned so far. This is clear? So this is how you can go ahead and use RDB methods and create connector scale rules and write down your own queries here. You need SQL knowledge for this, but minimum basic SQL knowledge of understanding existing and modifying would be good. Okay. So this is about RDB methods. See, I have told you, right? Table and class mappings and all, that is not required if you are working with RDB methods. If you are working with RDB methods, database connection is done. These queries you can write down, and RDB methods you can use directly. There is no need of table and class mapping, which is not mandatory. Okay. So look at here now. We have an activity created for fetching OBJ browse activity, browse states activity. Let me go ahead and run this. When you run this activity, it will generate two queries. Two queries are being held to two different properties, ODB properties. Can you tell me what are the properties that we have discussed already? So what queries will be generated first of all?
When you use
RDB method, what are the queries that get generated?
PXP SQL statement, post SQL statement.
PXSQL statement, post SQL. So pre-SQL, post SQL. Properties which holds all this is SQL statement pre and SQL statement post. Okay, here you go. According to the states list. And SQL statement pre, SQL statement post, which I have done. Look at the pre-statement first. In the pre-statement, we have query like this. Suppose if you're going to write down like this. In the connect SQL rule, where is connect SQL rule? Sorry. Just to show you, in connect SQL rule, if you're going to write a query like this. Okay, now this query has class name instead of physical table. Generally, in the database, if a query is going to hit the database, it should be in database required format of having all the table names and all. Suppose if I am going to run this activity using OBJ RDB open method and pass the respective parameters, this tab will be executed. When this tab is executed, this class name will get converted into actual physical table name that will be assigned to post query. This is pre query or writing. It will be converted into post query, and the post query is going to hit the database. For this class name to get converted into table name. Okay, can you tell me how PRPC resolves this class name into table name at runtime? How it can resolve? It is going to read for this class name, it will identify the database table class mapping rule. From that, it will read the physical table name, and then post query will be generated. That means while you are using RDB methods, if you are writing queries like this, then database class and database table mapping is mandatory. Instead of this, I can go and write down like this. Suppose it's like table name. What is the table name? Win details table. Select star from win details table. And if you run this, this will also work fine because you are directly giving the table name. You are directly writing a post query in the database in the query tab. If you directly write post query, without any issues, it is going to hit the database and it will work fine. If your way of writing queries is directly with the hard-coded table names, then there is no need to create class and table mapping. This time, do we need any class table mapping? Class table mapping is required only when your queries have class names. Okay. In order to get that class name to be resolved into table name, you need class and table mappings to be created. Else, while working with RDB methods, it's not mandatory that your class and database table is going to get mapped. Simply, you can go ahead and write down queries without any class names. Directly, if you're writing queries without class names, hard coded table names and all, then you can, there is no class and table mapping required. Suppose if your queries you are going to write down like with class names and all, then class and table mappings are mandatory. This is clear. Suppose if you are working with OBJ methods, then is there a way that you can write down queries in the tab and execute that? No way. If you are working with OBJ methods for external database, then class table mapping is must. So if you wanted to bring the data from external database or internal database, any database, if you are using OBJ methods, class table mapping is must. If you're using RDB methods, class table mapping is optional. If the queries that you're going to write have class names, then class table mapping is required. Else, class table mapping is not required. But tell me, writing a query with direct table names or writing a query with class names instead of table names, which one is better, best practice? Why? Which one is best practice and why? See, either of the type of the queries that you write, mappings to the clipboard, data getting to the clipboard will happen for sure. That is okay. Which approach would be better? Like writing hard-coded table names or writing class names instead of table names? Hard-coded table names will be a bit faster than normal one still. But still, which one is better? Why? Dynamically, అక్కడ డైనమిక్ గా ఇచ్చేదే ఉండదు చెప్పండి. సో డిఫైనింగ్ రైటింగ్ ద క్వరీస్ విత్ క్లాస్ నేమ్ వుడ్ బి బెటర్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వై క్లాస్ నేమ్స్ ఇస్ బెటర్ దాన్ హార్డ్ కోడెడ్ టేబుల్ నేమ్స్? What could be the reason? Someone guess and tell me. Chapani. From table name same on the required database. Different schema on table, we will give schema name dot table name. So there won't be any such situation like table names being same. Chapani. Why it is better to write with class names instead of hard coded table names? Any changes to the database class name? Yes. Suppose in database, suppose if you are writing hard coded table names and all, from database and table name is changed, then from PRPC what you should do? You have to change the table names in the queries. How many places? All the queries you need to identify, you need to perform a search through the content and a number of connect SQL rules. This table is being used at all the places. You have to identify and manually update. Suppose if you write class table mapping is there and table name is changed, then where do we need to make the change? Only in the class and table mapping rule only. If you make updates, that would be fair enough. Okay, that is why it is better to go. So like this, you can go and use RDB method. Suppose, look at here. If you are using OBJ browse for external database, I'm using OBJ browse, query will get automatically generated, right? For external tables and all, if you are using OBJ browse, you must have to uncheck get row key. Why? OBJ dynamic key will not be available in the external database. OBJ browse, if you are using for external database, you must have to uncheck get row key, because external databases will not have OBJ dynamic key, but internal rule base will have OBJ dynamic rule base tables. And you cannot use OBJ open by handle, OBJ open by handle, or OBJ delete by handle methods to external database tables. What is the reason? Same reason. Feature INS key will not be available in the external database. And apart from that, while using OBJ open, you have lock option available. If you select this option for external database, is it going to work? It will not work. For external database in the OBJ open, lock method, lock checkboxes release and commit will not work. So because PRPC cannot acquire locks on external tables, that and all, it cannot do. It can do only for internal rule based tables. That is how system is designed. Okay. It will not throw an error. It will not have any impact at all because nothing will be found there. Okay, related to locking. So like this, you have certain restrictions. This is related to OBJ and RDB. OBJ, if you want to use OBJ methods, OBJ methods will work both on internal database tables as well as external database tables with little restrictions. While you are using OBJ for external database, OBJ bounce get row key should be unchecked. OBJ open by handle, OBJ delete by handle cannot be used. Lock and release on commit will not have any impact at all. Okay. So now external database methods, when you are your RDB methods, I'm sorry, when you are using RDB methods, you need to write your own queries, the queries in connect SQL rules and pass the parameters. Okay. RDB methods can go ahead and can be used for external database tables. Can we use RDB for internal database tables, rule based tables? Can we use or not? Similarly, on my work table, I'll write a connect SQL rule and write my own query and use RDB methods. It will fetch the data. But only difference is RDB methods can fetch data only from normal columns, but not from the blob column. PZ PV stream, if you write as part of your select class, data that is going to be retrieved will be retrieved in blob format. You cannot do anything with blob. It will not be decrypted. But if you use OBJ methods will fetch the data from normal columns as well as blob column by decrypting the data. That is another difference. OBJ methods can fetch, OBJ methods can be used for internal as well as external tables. RDB methods can be used for internal as well as external tables. OBJ methods can fetch the content available in normal columns as well as blob column and can be decrypted. But while you're using RDB, it will fetch the content only from exposed columns. In the content inside blob cannot be fetched, but blob will be fetched as it is blob. Okay, blob will be fetched as blob only, binary format only. It will fetch, no error message, nothing. You cannot make use of the data anymore. Okay, encryption, decryption will not happen. This is clear, everyone? You got an idea about now what is external database and what is internal database and what methods we can use for external and internal databases. Both can be used, but while using RDB methods, we have to write our own connect SQL rules. While using RDB methods, table and class mappings are optional. If you're writing your queries with class names, then table class mapping is mandatory. Else, what is that? Table class mapping is not mandatory. Okay, this document is available with references. I'll share that. Can someone please mute online? I'll just let me tell you another point. You remember how BRPC works is whenever you are going to fetch the data from a table, it will be placed on the clipboard on the respective table related page. Here the condition is table class properties and table columns must exactly match by names and data types and case sensitive too. Suppose if your table has a column win and your property is win, what happens? The data that will be retrieved will not be assigned to this property. PRPC will add a property automatically win and assign to that. So your program will not work properly. Okay, your expectation to assign this and use this anyway, even though it will be virtually added, it cannot be used in your program. So like this, if you have differences, see, in your PRPC already you have a class and properties available. Now there is some external table which you wanted to access. It's not by cases. Maybe column names also can be a little different. Suppose PRPC and you have a property name like this, win number. External database column name is win underscore number, like this. Matching, not matching, but still you wanted to retrieve the data and assign to this property only. So by default, it is not possible. For that, we need to do one additional task. That is, you need to open the table class and go to external mapping. So here you need to add column name exactly win underscore number. This is the column should be assigned here to a property win simply. So whenever you are fetching the data from this column, that will be assigned in the BRPC to a property win on clipboard on the respective table page. This one we are going to practically do while we are working. Okay, this is clear, everyone. This is another point. So always it is a practice that from BRPC, if you are fetching the internal table data or external table data, column names and the property names in the class must exactly match. If not matching in the class name, we have to go to external mapping tab and then mention the mapping of which column to which property. Here you have to mention the property. You can choose it from the drop down itself. Okay, this is clear. Like this you have to do external mapping. Everyone clear so far? Online resources, are you clear? So I'll share this document to you. Satish, give a WhatsApp message, we will add. Pratima will add that. Give a message on WhatsApp number, the other number like office number 567. So we're going to work on this requirements tomorrow. Write down business requirement. Write down business requirement. Make changes to the existing SOAP surveys. Make changes to existing SOAP surveys. Everyone just make a note of it. Make changes to existing SOAP surveys design. SOAP surveys design as described below. Make changes to existing SOAP surveys as described below. Okay, write down that. The existing surveys is interacting with internal win details table. Is interacting with win details table, write on this way. The existing SOAP surveys is interacting with win details table, which is available in rule base, which is available in rule base. Okay. What we need to do now? Okay, write down. Going forward, the service should fetch the win details. Going forward, the service should fetch win details from an external table. Which is available in external database, AAAExtDB. This is what already design is being done, fetching from the internal database that we have implemented long back. Same we have to modify now as a change request. getting the data from external table instead of internal. For this, we'll use RDB. Okay. Everyone clear? So this is what we're going to work on tomorrow.